6:20 to go in the first. Notre Dame has that 1-0 lead. There's a stick down just outside the Notre Dame blue line where the puck is. Power fed up ahead. It hit the stick. UMass fires and scores. And once again, it's Frank Vetrano. Vetrano scores for the third straight game. And with 6:13 to go in the first, UMass 1, Notre Dame 1.
Well, that will be certainly a subject of conversation, that piece of lumber that lay just outside the blue line. The puck hit it, Cody. The Irish were trying to clear the puck out of the UMass zone. The clearing pass, it looked like, hit the stick. And it was Frank Vetrano who came in right between the top of the faceoff circles, let it snap, went glove side low.
UMass with Vetrano up the near side boards, head man pass, Jakubelis connects with the trailer, wrist shot fired and scored! Shane Walsh took the feed at the left wing circle and went top shelf over Tannenar. And just 25 seconds into the second period, UMass 2 and Notre Dame 1 here in Amherst. Canestroza running point on this power play back to Grusso. Now the shot fired, deflected. UMass not going to clear. UMass going to try to break up the other way. Here's Vetrano, 2-on-1. Vetrano scores shorthanded. He intercepted the pass, went flying up the near side boards. And with 9:48 to go in the second, it's another shorthanded goal for UMass, the second of the night for Vetrano. And it's UMass with a 3-2 lead over Notre Dame.
Using his forward as a decoy, Vetrano, Frank had his head down. He was shooting all the way. He's going to let that heavy shot, as we call it, go. It took a snapshot. You could hear it just rang off the inside of the post. This is near side as we look down to our left. Stick side of the Notre Dame goaltender. 10-12 the time. Shorthanded. The Minutemen have a 3-2 lead.
Petrella tried to center. It was off the skate of a Notre Dame defender. UMass, though, maintains the handle. Baxendahl. Back to Petrella, trying to jam it home on the near side. Whistle blew. He got decked down to the ice. Baxendahl tangled up with a couple of Notre Dame players in the crease. And did the puck go in? They're going to point to the goal. I think the puck went in, and UMass just scored a goal.
I think you're right. The referee looked like he was pointing at the net.
They flashed the lights here, which they do with the goal. The official was pointing right down at the goal. There were bodies all over the crease. UMass has pulled the goalie. Extra attacker out there. Burchette right up the center of the slot. Fires, and it's a save by Kadenar. He lost the puck. It trickles in, and UMass scores to cut it to 1 with a minute and 32 seconds to go.
And that was led up by Keith Burchette again. Truly one of the unsung players in this game, I think.
Troy Powers scored, and Keith Burchette was the one who really ran point on that play.
Yes, he did. Yes, sir. Up the far side, left wing boards. He's the one that carried it out, and as you said, really ran the whole show.
Notre Dame pops the puck free. Far side, there's the whistle. And UMass gives up 4 early goals in the third period. They had a 1-goal lead heading into the final frame. And then Notre Dame, after UMass pulls within 1, picks up an empty net tally. And the final score, UMass falls to Notre Dame here in Amherst by a score of 7-5.